The Thai parliament finally chooses a new prime minister, poll second placer for Thais Srettha Thavisin, whose vote so far exceeds the simple majority required. And on the same day the chamber made its choice, the country also saw the return of former leader Thaksin Shinawatra.
For more insight, Jay Harriman joins us live. He is in Bangkok. He's the senior director from BowerGroupAsia. Good evening to you, Mr. Harriman, and thank you for joining us. Your reaction, first of all, to the end of what we've seen, 3 months of political deadlock in Thailand. They've chosen a prime minister, but he's not from the party that the people voted for in May. How significant is this result for the vote for him? And does it end Thailand's political troubles?
Yeah, thank you. And let me first start by saying it's been an incredible day here politically, one that I haven't seen in some time. I mean, former Prime Minister Thaksin coming back after 17 years in exile. You know, we've seen Suthep Thuksaban, who was a protest leader who protested against Thaksin to have him removed from office, had his court cases were dismissed. And then finally, later in the afternoon, we had Srettha Thavisin confirmed as the new Prime Minister of Thailand. So it's been quite a day here. I think, in sum, I would say that in many ways it's confirmed suspicions that we've had that, you know, today was a very carefully crafted political deal whereby Thaksin's coming back to Thailand was in exchange for giving the military-backed parties an important role in the new government.
Mr. Harriman, that coincidence or the perception that it may have been a coincidence or perhaps less of a coincidence aside, let's talk a little bit about what Pheu Thai now faces, because they've said they might control at least 8 cabinet posts and 9 deputy cabinet posts as well. What will Mr. Srettha's priorities be as a leader?
Right. I think number one, the economy is going to be the number one priority for Srettha and the party. I think they've rested their legitimacy on the economy and being able to revive it sort of in exchange for doing this deal with the opposition that, you know, arguably many in the party didn't support. And as you mentioned at the opening there, that, you know, the party that won the most seats isn't the one that's leading the government. If you look at Thailand's GDP for this year, it's expected to come in at 3.9%. But you know, versus the neighbors like the Philippines or Vietnam, which are around 6%, you know, Thailand is trailing. Srettha has made the economy his focal point, and he's, you know, introduced this digital wallet policy that would give about $300 to every citizen over 16 years old. He's also said that they'll increase the minimum wage, reduce regulations on businesses, and also increase investment incentives, as well as streamline taxes, but not increase them. So I would say that, you know, perhaps his biggest challenge is going to be with the different ministries and the fact that, you know, for him to implement the party's economic policy, he's going to need the cooperation of the other coalition partners. And currently, it looks like the economic ministries might be split up, with Pheu Thai having, you know, finance and transport. Luom Thai Sang Chat might have the energy portfolio, Phum Jai Thai commerce. And so the fact that these will be distributed among different parties might make it difficult for him to implement his economic policy. So I think we're cautiously optimistic. The fact that this 3 months of uncertainty is finally finished, that should improve investor and business sentiment. But I think at the end of the day, we also need to remember, you know, that the Thai economy is heavily dependent on exports and tourism. So sort of no matter what the government does to stimulate, you know, it's still dependent on external forces. And, you know, recently global trade has slowed down. And we've also seen in recent days, actually, news out of China has been a little bit negative.
Mr. Harriman, there will also be hope among Pheu Thai's, or at least the Pheu Thai Alliance's supporters, that this election of Srettha Thavisin, that it will hold in the weeks, in the months ahead, mm-hmm. once he is actually receives that post and he actually is sworn in. Pheu Thai, after all, are sharing power with members of the conservative elite. That's something they said they wouldn't do. They've also joined hands with the party backed by Mr. Prayut Chan-o-cha, something they said they wouldn't do as well. Mr. Thavisin has to ensure that the base here, the party's base, isn't going to be eroded. What does he need to actually do to ensure that that doesn't happen?
Yeah, I think he'll need to do a couple things, at least from the grassroots perspective and those voters. You know, reviving the economy is going to be key. I think many of them feel like that they've been sold out, that they didn't sort of support this deal when they went to the ballot box, that this deal wasn't in their favor. So in order to win back their support, if they can do it, they're going to have to revive the economy. I think second, as far as the internal party politics go, you know, key portfolios are going to be needed to be given to the factional heads. You know, for example, the transport or interior finance ministry will probably go to key faction leaders that control different provinces and vote bases. And lastly, you know, I think for Srettha to be able to control his position within the party, he's going to need to gain popularity with the public and display a real political acumen that we don't know whether he has or not, and then use that as sort of a leverage point against the party. He has a business background, CEO of Sansiri Property Management Company. And so we'll see if he's able to translate that into some economic success for the party.
Mr. Harriman, thank you for that. Jay Harriman there from Bauer Group Asia.